Hey fam, Chelsea from Chelsea As of Late here, and today I'm taking you guys thrifting with me. I cannot wait. The thrifts have been open for about a month now and I've been thrifting consistently, and I figured today I would bring you guys with me. So we are doing a full day of thrifting, starting with one of my favorites in the New York, New Jersey area, which is My Unique. I'm starting off in the Westbury? One of these Long Island spots. I'll like leave the information here for you guys, and then we're gonna go to another one, and then we're gonna go to the bins for the grand finale. So let's do it. Let's see what we can find. Location number one. Honestly, it took me longer than I expected because I wasn't finding that many gems, and I was kind of like pushing it. Like I was going through every rack and like picking out every single item trying to find those gems, and it just was not working. Also, I felt like the prices were like jacked up a bit. Like I was finding like t-shirts for like $15, although they did have 50% off. Today's 50% off day. So yeah, it was just like, it was a whole lot of, but not giving up yet. We're going to the bins and I'm sure we're gonna find some gems there. Putting out the good thrifting vibes.
So this is not gonna happen.
Cool. Bins were not a moment. They were not gonna happen. And so, yeah, I am gonna go to Michael's instead. Not as successful as I expected, but you know what? You take what you can get. That is the beauty of thrifting. So I'll meet you guys at home with a haul. All right, so we are back home, done thrifting. As you guys saw, I went to my favorite thrift, My Unique, only one of them, because I wanted to rush back to make it to the bins. And then I saw that line and I was like, absolutely not. We are not making that line in this super hot summer day. But then the next day I started thinking, I'm like, wait a second, what if this isn't the line to get in but the line for the new bins when they come out, you know, that whole rush thing? And lo and behold, it was. I actually ended up going the next day and I got in right away. So I did find some things, but actually this time around I made a list. I don't usually go into the thrift with the list because I just like to see like what's out there. Usually, obviously, I shop for seasonal things and things I can wear now, but it doesn't always work that way. Avid thrifters know that, you know, you get what you get and you don't get upset. So yeah, I kind of wanted to make a list to guide my shopping experience a little bit this time, and this is what I had on my list. So I had mom jeans because I did a huge closet clean out, got rid of like 90% of my jeans. Bermuda shorts that I can cut and like customize. I wanted red boots, which I actually found, but that's, hold on that. I wanted chunky sandals, also found, didn't work out. I wanted car t-shirts, y'all. These car t-shirts,
be hidden different.
But again, we'll get to that. Jewelry, I'm always looking for like fun vintage looking jewelry, summer pants, and bucket hats. So let's see what I actually found. So we're gonna start with, let's start with intimates and delicates, why not? If y'all haven't been put on, let me put you on. The thrift store intimates loungewear section is truly, like, you find so many gems. They are not only actual peaches and things you can wear for like to go to sleep or around the house, but slips, camis, like the best materials, the best colors, the best everything. So this is what I found this time around. I usually pick up at least one piece from this section. This is kind of like a slip. If it was a tiny bit longer, I would actually wear this as a dress with a blazer on top, but it is actually very short, so I'm actually gonna use it as a night slip, like a PJ. Next thing is actually this cami. This one's a little bit more tight. I usually like them a little looser, but I realized that all my camis are kind of loose, so I figured I have to get one that's like a little bit more form-fitting for, like, you know, depending on the outfit that I'm trying to put together. So this one just had really nice lace detail that I really liked, and I tried it on and it worked. So
Okay, this one. So this is actually gonna be a slip dress. Again, a little bit more form-fitting for me, but it actually works for, you know, certain looks that I'm trying to put together. I was even thinking, once it starts cooling down a little bit, throwing like a chunkier sweater over it and just seeing like the bottom lace detail. And I also really enjoyed, the straps are a little bit like stained, but I really enjoyed the thicker strap for some reason. I thought that was a really nice detail. Okay, now we're going to move on to tops. I actually found a lot of t-shirts and more like casual wear this time around, but I really am happy with the pieces that I found, so let me show you guys. Let's start with this. So I didn't end up finding any car t-shirts, unfortunately, in either thrift, but I found this like Minnesota, just like almost like a souvenir t-shirt, I guess, that kind of had the font and the feel of what you're seeing in these like vintage car t-shirts. So I just really liked, yeah, just like the colors and like the graphic and everything, and I thought it would be like fun and funky. The next one, ooh, this one was a gem. So found this already tie-dyed, don't even have to do the work, t-shirt. Again, in the men's department. Oh, that one was the men's department. I'm not sure if I said that. This is also the men's department. Honestly, we all know the men's department has the best t-shirts. So it was like a tie-dye that I don't already own, like a tie-dye combination that I don't own. It's a little bit more punchy in the colors. It's very vibrant, so I really enjoyed that. And this is something I could wear like right away. It's obviously very trendy this summer, so love, love, love that. The next one is a really fun piece, and it's this like patchwork gingham colorful short sleeve button down top. I know, she a mouthful, but I just really enjoyed the colors. I enjoyed that it's something that I've never seen before, like this combination of gingham and a top. I like that I can either chop it or just tie it around, make it shorter. I could also wear it like tucked into things, roll the sleeves up. It's just a fun top, like a fun unexpected top for summer. But it's also very simple, so you could do a lot with it. You could layer it, not layer it. So she's a lot, but I like her. She's a lot and she's not at the same time. Kind of like me. Next piece is something that I'm gonna have to experiment with a little bit. I saw Notorious KIA here on YouTube. She has this like really cool Knicks jersey, also sleeveless. I guess all NBA jerseys are sleeveless. Sports. That she chopped and she wears in like the dopest street style way ever. And for a while I had this thing where I would thrift like a lot of like jerseys and like more sportswear things, but like I just couldn't style it like to look cool. It just looked weird. I'm gonna give it another try and you guys will see another piece in that same subject. So I found this Islanders jersey. It's hockey, but this is not a hockey jersey, so make it make sense. But I figured, I'm not a huge hockey person, like it won't hurt me if I like chop in and it doesn't work. Like it's just an experiment piece, so we'll see. Hopefully you guys see how I style this on Instagram. If you don't follow me already, I am Chelsea as of late on all platforms. Keeping in the same kind of train of thought, I found this one. It's another kind of jersey-esque top. I really enjoyed how the mesh detail kind of like makes it cool to layer with. So like if I have a cool bralette or like a nice little top underneath, like it's like you could see it, so it's cool. So, okay, so let's go into t-shirts. I found this at the Goodwill bins and someone had just put it up or put it back and I couldn't pass it up, and it's this. I don't need to say anything, you guys already know what it is. So I was like, okay, you're coming home with me. Cool, cool, cool. And then the last t-shirt that I'm going to show you guys is this one. She was a little pricey, honestly. She was $10 with the 50% off, so it was $5, but $5 for a t-shirt at the thrift is kind of a lot. But I'm a super fan of all things like tiger print and tiger and leopard and animal. So I just thought this was like a different take on that. Just put my lipstick all over it. That's great. I love that for us. But what I really liked about this one is the print. So it has this like, I don't know, very 80s like micro print with like the fun red and yellow. And I'm definitely looking to chop this one. And the last top is this button down. She is a lacy number. I don't know if I mentioned in my list that I was looking for lacy tops, but she is a lacy, but she's also like shimmery and shiny. She has like a sheen, that's what it is. I really enjoyed about her, and I'm picturing this buttoned all the way up with like a black bow tied in the middle for more of like a romantic feel. Oh, actually I have one more top I want to show you guys. Scratch that, two more tops. So the first one is another kind of like lacy top that I found at the bins. She is a mock neck, she's lacy. She looks like this, and what I'm thinking is, because the reason why I want all these like lacy tops, not that one in particular, but like more plain lacy tops, is to layer underneath things. So what I'm planning to do is just chop this lining completely off so that she is all lace underneath. A lot of experiments happening with this thrift haul, but honestly I will say it was kind of dry, so we had to, you know, get creative. And then the next top, y'all are gonna think I'm crazy. I found at the bins, and she was a full dress when I found her. She was a full potential wedding dress. I'll try to insert a picture here, but she had a full train behind. Like, it was like 99% a wedding dress, which made her actually very heavy at the bins. But when I saw the details up top of this number, I knew I had to do something with it. Also, I've been watching way too much Bea Jones lately, Bea Jones style, and she does this all the time. Like, she finds dresses and chops them into tops. So yeah, that was in the back of my mind. I saw the lace or the embroidery details, and I just like, I knew it. I knew I had to. You can even see like the zipper here that I couldn't obviously like maneuver. I'm not a seamstress, I'm not at all well versed in like sewing and all those things, so I just cut away, and this is just gonna be an under top. Moving on to jeans. I said I wanted to find mom jeans, and boy did I. I literally came home with like four new pairs of jeans. Starting with these guys by Arizona. All three jeans are mom jeans, or they fit me like mom jeans. I just got like different washes to do different things with them. These are Levi's. These I found in the men's section. And it's, you know, just like a lighter wash. I found these Lee jeans. Also a lighter wash. So these, I'll keep one and then as is, and then customize the other probably, so. And the last bottom was actually this wrap skirt, which is very me at the moment. I'm super into color. Just like a midi, almost maxi wrap skirt in this fun like lime green color with these flowers on it. So super cute, very fun piece for the summertime. Okay, the last clothing piece is this baby. I found her at the bins, and it's not summer at all, but I could not pass her up. This is chocolate brown. Y'all, I usually don't gravitate towards brown, but I just saw it and I knew. It has like this like 80s like shoulder detail, amazing condition. And what I'll probably do is just like add a bunch of brooches or pins, or just like zhuzh her up in some way for fall. Okay, let's move on to accessories. Okay, the first thing I found was this little brown bag that was not in the best condition. She's just like a tiny backpack, and then I just added a bunch of bead embroidery patches to it because it's what I do. I just patch everything up. Yeah, it just kind of like elevated it a little bit. I just love bags like this for when I go shopping because they're just like super comfortable, but they fit exactly what I need to fit. So I knew I couldn't pass this up. It was at the bin, so it was probably a couple bucks. And yeah, I just gave her a little facelift, which I love. Okay, the next bag that I found was this super cute kind of like structured square straw floral super summer bag. She has this like single handle, which I love. It's just like, it's just a cute little summer accessory, so I loved her. Okay, now this baby I found at the bins, and y'all, how freaking cool is this bag? It's so cute. She's super small. It has this like almost like patch feel to these different like colors and textures and prints, and then it's like met at the center with this like beautiful almost like brooch like it's just perfect. I loved her at first sight and I could not leave her. This next one is more of a simple just like beige bag. Give me a little bit of Chanel feels. It's just like a quilted square bag, and it has a double zipper, so more storage for me. Moving on to shoes. I actually did pretty well in shoes. TBH. So the first are something that I didn't necessarily knew I wanted or needed, but once I did find it, I was like, I need you in my life. There are these black clogs with this like silver detail all around the heel. Very like Y2K-ish, almost like late 90s Y2K. But yeah, once I put them on with socks, they were just like super cool and I knew I needed it. And
this part.
Oh, it's good. Hot in here. Nothing on your clothes. Moving on to loafers. Next pair are these black loafers. I was looking for loafers specifically because I know I want to do different things with them. One of my favorite labels or, you know, design houses is Gucci, so I'm very inspired by all things Gucci. And I wanted to create my own little like DIY Gucci loafer. So I found these. They're originally by Enzo Angiolini. I can't say the brand, but I know it's a good one. They fit really, really nicely. So yeah, they're just these like plain black loafers with a little bit of a heel. What I'm gonna do to these babies is actually add the pearl detail that you see in like a lot of the Gucci heels. Just like zhuzh her up, make her really fun. And then I got a second pair. These are Easy Spirit, also just like a plain black kind of heeled loafer. These I got from the bins, and what I'm gonna do with this one is add a ribbon to the front with a brooch or a, you know, like jewel detail. Also very Gucci of me, but you know, a girl's gotta do what a girl's gotta do with her budget. So we're making Gucci at home now. And then we have what I consider to be my best find and my worst at the same time. They are these red cowboy boots that I found at the bins. They have these like French details all around the boot and the side of the boot. They're in great condition, almost perfect. This one has a little bit of like a chip somewhere here. And they don't fit.
You feel like it's upsetting me, I'm a homegirl fat.
When I said red boots, I meant these. Like these are the red boots. Like I don't have any cowboy boots. I've been holding out to find the perfect pair, and I thought I did. And then I tried them on in the store and my foot fit, so I fit like immediately. I was like,
you're coming home, I don't care.
But then when I tried it on, when they tried them on at home, they're too tight. They're way too tight, and I probably couldn't last more than like 10 minutes standing with them. So I'm gonna have to sell these. They're gonna have to find a new home. They're originally by a brand called Dingo, which I looked up and they retail for like $100 and upward. So moment of silence for the red boots that I won't get to keep and make them mine. If anyone is interested, I'll leave my Poshmark below. Find these at home. I think that is it, you guys. This was a big one. For some reason, I thought I didn't find that many things, but now that I'm doing a haul, I'm like, damn, I kind of did. I kind of found a lot. Thank you guys so much for watching if you're still here. The very end of it all. I'm looking to do more thrift hauls a little bit more consistently, looking at like maybe once a week or once every few weeks, because I've been thrifting like a maniac lately. If you don't follow me already, I am Chelsea S of Late on all platforms, Instagram, Pinterest, obviously YouTube, Facebook. Is anyone on that? Anyone on there? TikTok. So you can find me there on all platforms. And if you want to see more thrift hauls, make sure you subscribe and hit the bell notification if that's what kids do. I'm really not sure. Let me know in the comments below what was your favorite piece. And with that, I say peace. Bye.